In this lecture, we will discuss about Cauchy Riemann equations. Cauchy Riemann equations consist of two partial differential equations, which form a sufficient condition for a complex function to check either it has a complex derivative or not. The first condition is partial u over partial x is equal partial v over partial y. And the second is partial u over partial y is equal to minus partial v over partial x. The first condition can also be written as u of x is equal to v of y. And the second condition we can also write as u of y is equal to minus v of x. Suppose we have a complex function f of z is equal u plus iota v, where u is real part and v is an imaginary part. And both are further functions of x and y. Then the complex derivative of this function at a point z naught can be defined as f prime of z naught is equal limit delta z tends to 0 f of z naught plus del z minus f of z naught over del z, provided that this limit exists. Now, taking limit, please note, if this limit exists, then it may be solved by taking the limit along a real axis and imaginary axis as well. In both cases, the result would be same. Now, taking a limit along a real axis, and that is delta x tends to 0, and keeping delta y is equal to 0. So by doing this, we can write this differential equation, which is in terms of u and v. So keeping limit delta x tends to 0 and delta y is equal to 0, we ultimately get this form, which further can be written in two parts. Here you can see the first part is a real part and the second part is an imaginary part. Now here we can identify partial derivatives with respect to x in both parts. You see, this is a partial derivative of u with respect to x, and this is a partial derivative of v with respect to x. But you see here, because only x is vary and all other variables are constant, hence we can say that this is the ordinary derivative of u with respect to x, and this is the ordinary derivative of v with respect to x, which further can be written as f prime of z naught is equal u of x plus iota v x. Let's call this equation A. Now, we repeat the same steps again, but this time we take limit along imaginary axis. And for that, we simply say delta y tends to 0 and delta x is equal to 0. And by repeating the same steps, now by keeping this time delta y limit tends to 0, here you can see we have the imaginary part for the function and the real part for the function. So now again we can identify this partial derivative with respect to y, and this is also partial derivative with respect to y. So this is nothing but minus iota u y, and this is v of y, which simply can be written as f prime of z naught is equal v of y minus iota u y. Let's call this equation B. Now, these two equations, A and B, can only be true if their real parts and imaginary parts are equal to each other. And here are our Cauchy-Riemann equations. After comparing the real and imaginary parts, you can see the first one, u of x is equal to v of y, and the second is v of x is equal to minus u y. If both equations are true for any given function, then the complex derivative of that given function will exist.